Hey everyone, it's Derek here with another video, and today we're talking about the Sunjo dethatcher slash scarifer. So I used it for the first time today, and it's because we have some pretty bad lawn, and what I wanted to do was run this here instead of raking the entire thing, because we got two rakes. It's pretty tough work to rake it, and this thing was something that we can use to rake and bag all of the dethatched grass that we wanted to do. So let me take you through a few things here. First things first is that this thing is electrically powered, and this one only comes with a plug. So it's one on Amazon that cost, I believe, $175. And yeah, there's not much to it. There's a lock switch here, so you have to push this down and then press this back, which is kind of funky, but I guess it's childproof-ish. And assembly is pretty straightforward. It doesn't all fit together, and it has two extra washers that it says it doesn't really give you directions on how to put it together. So basically, this comes separately in two pieces. So this black bar here, and then this black bar here, and then it attaches to this handle here. So you have to put these two together, and then you have to put this one down here together. So you push this one in, screw this in. It's a little bit finicky, but it'll take you a little bit. And then these two here, there's a square bolt here that fits into this, and then yeah, you tighten it up, and then that's basically it. And then all of the rest of this comes together, and then the only other thing here is the adjuster. So you basically push this in here to raise or lower it. So once you push it in here, then you can raise it or lower it. So I use the deepest port, so you can dig in as close to the ground as possible, and hopefully that works. I'll give another update on this video on if my grass is even growing or not. But let's check in underneath here. This is a little bit finicky here, as I was opening and closing this all the time. So you can see this here. Sometimes it opens nice and easily, and sometimes it does not. And underneath here is where you can put your bag. And your bag hooks into this and this, and it's pretty straightforward, but it's kind of janky as well. And the other issue with the bag is that it's really small, so this thing will fill it up with just doing a run of like maybe 10 feet or something like that. So that's one of the issues. Wish it had a bigger bag. And underneath here, you can see the attachment right now is the scarifer. So let me get you a little bit closer to that. Just as a disclaimer, make sure this thing is not plugged in and the safety is off, and this thing is not running. Just make sure that's the case. So here you have the scarifer attachment, and this one's kind of like, after you dethatch, you scarif, because it's kind of like aerating, but it's not like the big chunks of the little circle pieces of mud and soil that it roots out, but it does a pretty good job after the dethatcher. And here is where the attachment is here. You take these two bolts off. These are 10 millimeter bolts, so pretty standard across the board. Take these two out. There's a washer and a crush washer, I think it's called, on here. So make sure you don't lose those. And once you take that out, this will come out, and then here's where it attaches to the motor, so then you can take it out that way. And this is the dethatcher attachment, so it's kind of like a rake, and it has some spring-loaded just rake module things that you can see here. And that's the other module that you can put in there. And essentially, that's the dethatcher, or a rake, if you will. And Yeah, this is the bag that it comes with, which is very, very small. If you want to compare that bag to my lawn mowing bag, you can see it's roughly maybe double or triple the size. And the lawnmower is just better at putting stuff in there and keeping it in there. After using this a few times, it's kind of a hassle to take it, to put it back in and take it out. As you can see here, there's the two spots where you're supposed to actually hook it into. And then this thing's a little bit janky because it always falls out. So there's some issues with that. And then just comparing this back and forth, I just wish it was a little bit bigger. So that's a quick look at the Sunjoe Dethatcher / Scarifer. And overall, the experience is pretty decent. I can show you some spots where I've done this and used it. So here's just a spot where I've done this, and you can't really see a huge gouge in here, but you can see it in some spots where this has occurred, but it's not quite, doesn't do quite a good job as an aerator, I don't think, but it's probably just a little bit better than a dethatcher from what I can see. But I'm putting some grass seed in here, overseeding, watering it, and we will see the results. But overall, I would just say some people have used this without the bag because it's kind of a pain that the bag fills up like every like maybe 10 feet. So one of the things that I would say is that if you are doing that, you still have to rake it and actually bag the dead grass that it pulls up. Because if you don't do that, essentially you have an issue with actually planting or seeding or whatever you're trying to do with your lawn. So that's one thing to note. So here's a good spot. You can see it's gotten a little bit deeper in there, and yeah, I'd say it's a pretty decent job for $175. But again, we'll see how it does. I did a lot today, so we'll see if we get any seed growing. It also depends on if these birds leave the seed alone. So again, we'll see if I'll set up another video to show you if this is successful or not for our lawn. So that is a quick view, if you will, of the Sunjoe Dethatcher / Scarifer. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments below, and I will see you in the next video. Thank you for watching.